Hey everybody, welcome back to White's World. Guess what I've been doing off camera, guys, if you can't tell already. I've been doing a lot of AFK fishing, actually, and I wanted to show you guys what I've gotten. So, as you can see, the chest area around here is pretty crazy. But I have been kind of splitting things off. So this row right here is all of my books, all the enchanted books that I have. And as you can see, there's a lot of them. We have three full double chests plus half a double chest right here. So that's a lot. All these over here, all these on the side are all the different materials that we got, all the different saddles and fishing rods and bows and whatnot. And all the extra stuff that we get with fishing, they're all on these extra spaces. So here, 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 yeah. And then on this side and a little bit, any over here? No. And then here, these two chests, these two double chests right here are all full of mending items. So mending rods, mending bows, and specifically mending books. Now, I have been putting mending on a few things already. I actually did put mending on my elytra. I also put mending on, I think, a piece of armor, something like that. And I also on my axe as well, because that was desperately needed. So we got all that stuff, and it's pretty awesome. Luckily, I got a mending and unbreaking book that was both mending and unbreaking on the same book, and I put that on my elytra, which was super handy. Didn't have to use up a whole bunch of levels for that. And of course, down here with the actual collection system of this stuff is, I have a lot of stuff down here as well. So we have a lot of stuff from fishing. I don't really know what I'm gonna do with all of it, to be honest. It's too much. We're gonna have to find a good storage system for it, which may come in the future, and things like that, because all this stuff, it's in here, and I don't know what to do with it, so we'll have to figure that out. But guys, I actually have been doing one more thing off camera that I want to show you guys. I talked a little bit last episode about tiers for shulker boxes, and down on the space below, down on the ground, I've kind of laid out a little something that I want to show you guys about shulker boxes. So let me head down this ladder, and I'll show you guys exactly what I've done. Guess who's a genius and just realized that he has elytra on, which makes things a lot easier where he doesn't have to actually go down a ladder. This guy. Yeah. Anyways, over here, I've established four different tiers of shulker boxes. We're going with four main colors for our shulker boxes. I don't really have any interest in any other colors for this series. I just want to use these four main colors. So let's go over them. Tier one is a suggestion I got last episode from Krishna, which was project boxes, which I think is a super cool idea. So essentially, all of these orange boxes, wherever we see orange shulker boxes, they'll be used specifically for projects. So I'll carry them around, and everything in these boxes will be used for whatever project they are near. So if we're working on a guardian farm, if we're working on a enderman farm, which hopefully we'll be doing pretty soon, if we're working on iron titan, something like that, or just big builds, all the items for those things will go in these project boxes, which is kind of the idea. And obviously I'll name these like project box one, project box two. And I will also, project boxes will include my ender pearl box as well. At least that's the plan for right now. So hopefully that'll be pretty good. Tier two, building materials, specifically building blocks, things like stone and wood and all that good stuff, including the stair and slab variants. Of course, I'll name these with whatever we need there. I'm not entirely certain yet if I want to put like farming supplies in the building materials or if I want to put those in tier three, which is decoration. So this will be things like saplings and things like carpet and glass and I think fences will probably go in building materials, but different things to decorate areas will go in these black boxes. And then last but not least, tier four, which is my favorite tier personally, which is rares and valuables. So this will be like right now we have our diamonds and our dragon egg and dragon head. And then we have our tools and we'll have an armor box and things like that. And also resources like extra iron, extra coal, stuff like that will all go in the rare slash valuable section. And it all should be pretty good, pretty handy. They're all color coordinated, white, black, red, and orange, going from tier four to tier one. I think it'll do pretty well. Let me know down in the comment section below, guys, what you guys think about this system. I think it pretty much covers everything that we're gonna need for this world. Hopefully it does. If I missed anything, please let me know. If you have any interest as to what will be in each, if any specifics that you want to know, please let me know. But other than that, guys, that's pretty much the shulker box things. I have to name these, of course, and all that good stuff, but that'll come in due time once I figure out exactly what I want each box to do. And obviously, we only have 11 shulker boxes as of right now. As we get more, we'll add them to their specific to a specific tier based upon different needs at the time. For instance, if we need more project boxes, we'll get more orange shulker boxes. If we need more building material boxes, we'll get more red boxes, etc., etc. And obviously, I want to have a whole fleet of these. So I would love to have at least 16 shulker boxes of each tier. That's kind of my goal, to be honest. So hopefully we can do that in the distant future. It'll be a little while. I would have to explore the end a lot, which I already explored it last episode, so I don't want to be doing that too much on camera with you guys. But yeah, hopefully that'll come in the near future. Anyways, guys, just kind of wanted to highlight those for today. As always, like I said earlier, if you have any suggestions, please leave them down in the comment section below. But without further ado, guys, let's go ahead and get on into today's episode. Wow, that actually went pretty high. I know, I'm wasting rockets. I did make about 24, I think, is enough gunpowder that I had. Or I had enough gunpowder to make that. But it's just so much fun. Like, if we just look at the kind of view that we can get up here in the air, this is just awesome. Like, this is really, really cool. I'm so glad we finally have a light. Anyways, guys, enough of the rambling and the awestruckness of myself. I have been looking down at this project board. I replaced a few things down here, and now we have a whole new set of things to do over the next how many episodes. So this right here is what I want to do today. Forget all this other stuff. We'll go over this later. You know, make a tree farm and portals and villager stuff and all that. That's in the future a little bit. Today, I want to make an Enderman farm, obviously, because the Enderman farms are known to be probably the most efficient of XP farms that you can have, and they're pretty easy to make, especially if you have an Endermite, and if you sort of know what you're doing, you can get a good Enderman farm done pretty quickly. So that's what I want to focus on for today. Hopefully we can at least finish the farm itself, maybe not decorate all of it, although I will see if I have the time to do so. If not, we'll do that next episode or in a live stream or something like that. Yeah, guys, let me go ahead and grab my project boxes. Let me go ahead and grab some materials. Let me head over to the end and let's get started on today's project. Before I forget, I'll put the comment for today up on the screen right now. It was actually from Luke, and he had a pretty good comment about the dragon fight, how easy it seemed for him as well. So I kind of feel better now knowing that I'm not alone in that. It seems like a lot of you guys felt the same way as well, though. But guys, as you can see, and as you probably already saw, I've been doing a lot around here. This is where our spawn, our 5x5 spawn area into the end is. I made this little pathway, and I realized after putting stone all the way down the 128 blocks I have to go this way, I realized that I should probably slab it. It'd be a lot easier because Enderman, of course, cannot spawn if you put it on the bottom half of the block. So I went ahead and slabbed this entire place. So it looks pretty good. We have a little 5-wide pathway right here. 5-wide pathway going that way. Things look pretty darn cool, if you ask me. And of course, this goes out 128 blocks, like I said. Just to be safe, I know that it only has to be about 128 from the edge of the island, but I wanted to make sure that I was at least 128 out. I know that those blocks could have conflicted, but those are like way back here, so we don't have to worry about those. But I went out 128 from this spot anyways, and it should work out pretty well for us. So if you guys don't know what design I'm using, I'm actually going to be using an Endermite design. I think Etho's used in the past. It's the most efficient and most popular design for an Enderman farm. So it's not going to be anything too special, but it's going to be super useful for us. I've always believed that Enderman XP farms are the best XP farms. I could be wrong. It could be gold farms. It could be something like that. But Enderman XP farms, pretty much the best. And from here, of course, we're going to be adding, actually, you should probably go get some slabs. We're going to be adding at least probably like a 17 by 17 or a 19 by 19 room, something like that. It'll probably be a box and won't be too special, just to have our stuff in, have probably a little storage area. It could just be storage. I may try to add a little enchanting area, but I may end up just making it storage. I'm not entirely certain yet. Obviously, I haven't built this thing yet, so a lot of things can still change, but I'm pretty confident that it's just going to be a huge storage area, one little space for Enderman to fall down into, and stuff like that. Also, I'll put the link to the tutorial that I'm using for this, because obviously it's a pretty popular design and I've built it before, but I just want to make sure that I'm doing it the way I want to. So I'll put a link to the tutorial that I use down in the description below. It's by GroovaGuy, who I've used in the past to make an Enderman farm. So I would highly recommend checking it out if you're looking to make an Enderman farm in your world. But guys, enough talking from me. I'm going to go ahead and get started on this farm, do a little bit of progress, and when I bring you guys back, we'll have a lot of progress done, and hopefully, I'll have the room built and an Enderman farm, the actual farm part at least, constructed and ready to go. So I wanted to take this time to kind of go a little bit further in depth about my response to Luke's comment. So to read off the actual comment, Luke Griffin said in the last episode, "In one of my most recent worlds, I fought the dragon and it was not particularly hard, but I fought it again a few days later and it seemed 100 times harder. I think that the fight can vary quite a lot, but in general is quite easy. As a builder, I do like the survival aspect, but I like that it isn't too hard and I can progress quite quickly and get on with my building." And I have to say, I agree and sort of feel the same way, but also don't feel the same way. I personally would like to see the fight be much more difficult, but I also find it very interesting that it varies. It seems to kind of vary in difficulty between one day and the next, and I wonder if that has something to do with respawning the dragon after you originally fight it. When I originally fought it, it didn't seem too difficult, but soon I want to go back and fight it again and see if it's any more difficult than the first time around, which would be a really interesting thing to try and do. I fought the Ender Dragon after the original fight a couple times before, so it's not like I'm completely new to this, but I would like to see if it is any more difficult. In the past, I haven't noticed it being any more difficult, but who knows? Maybe they change things, maybe in the snapshots or the more recent updates, because obviously I haven't fought the dragon in a couple updates now. I probably fought it back in 1.9 or 1.10 or something like that. So I haven't fought it in a little while, so maybe they changed some stuff, maybe they didn't. Be nice to go back and see. But I do agree with Luke's comment when he says that the building aspect, it is nice that the survival aspect isn't necessarily that difficult. So that you go on the building, just get the dragon done, get the elytra done, get all that done. I personally enjoy building a lot more than the Ender Dragon fight and that survival bit. I love adventuring, but I don't necessarily love surviving. So getting that done quicker can be a beneficial thing, but I personally would like to see it be more difficult. I don't know how difficult it can actually be, though. This is Minecraft. The game isn't that difficult to begin with, so in terms of like the actual story mode portion of it, obviously all the intricacies of it, like building and redstone, that stuff is more difficult, but the actual survival part and getting to the end and quote unquote completing the game is actually not too difficult once you get used to the game and you get more experience at it. But still, I would love to see the fight be more difficult. Still, I don't know necessarily how they would make it more difficult, but it would be pretty cool to see it be more difficult, in my opinion. But yeah, thank you, Luke, for the comment. Thank you all so much for all your wonderful comments last episode. I see so many wonderful comments right here, and it's always nice seeing people interacting in the comment section, seeing you guys still enjoying the videos, still liking the videos, which, by the way, guys, 50 likes last episode in the matter of a couple days or something, so that's pretty awesome. So thank you guys so much for the support. Thank you guys for all your comments and for continuously coming back to the videos and leaving awesome comments like Luke's and several others that I saw down in the comments section. So as always, thank you. But without further ado, guys, I've been doing a little bit of stuff in the end. Let's go ahead and get back into today's episode so I can explain to you guys what's happening and what's going to be going on for the rest of today's episode. As you can see, progress has been made. I put in some temporary glass, some temporary ceiling, all that kind of stuff, just so that we have a place to have the Enderman spawn once we get, once we get this gone and this gone all the way down like that. Once we get the actual farm in, which will be this episode, we'll have our little rings right here all the way up to the endermite up there, which I'll work on in just a minute. But guys, I've been doing this off camera as well. As you can see, Endermen are spawning on it already. But I actually have a tunnel design from where we spawn in into the end all the way over to here. And I've done it in a creative world. It looks pretty good, in my opinion. So I guess, without saying much else, let's go ahead and head on over to that creative world so I can show you exactly what kind of tunnel design I've decided to go with and why I decided to go with it. Here we go. So this is what I decided, and I think it's going to work really well for our tonal design from the area that we spawn into the end all the way to our Enderman farm. As you can see, we have these purple, what are those pillars? Yeah, purple pillars on the sides, five blocks in between, purple pillar. Pretty simple design, pretty uniform, and then the rest of this stuff is what I'm really excited about. We're using stone, not stone, we're using sandstone stairs, top and bottom right here. They blend pretty well with the end stone, which we're using in the middle and on the two sides. Using some white concrete back here, as you can see, some regular purple blocks. Just give it a little bit of contrast, that's the same on both sides. And for our lighting, because I was originally thinking about doing lighting as redstone lamps or something like that, but we have end rods, and we have quite a few end rods. I don't know if we'll have enough to do the entire tunnel today, but this produces quite a bit of light, and it looks pretty good in my opinion. They serve pretty well as fences and whatnot. So I really like it. I really like the fact that we're able to use these end rods in some sort of build. It looks pretty darn good. I have all these resources, by the way, off camera. I went ahead and went and tore down almost an entire end city. So I have a bunch of end stone. I have a bunch of end rods. I have a bunch of purple and whatnot. And I do have some white concrete as well. We may not have enough because on the ceiling here, we have, of course, a row of end stone and we have rows of white concrete. So we may not have enough for the ceiling, but I think it all looks pretty good. And last but not least, the part that's the most important, the part you're probably wondering, white, why is there carpet on the ground? Well, as you can see, there is packed ice. Is this packed ice? Yes, there is packed ice underneath of the carpet, which you can still run on, such as so. You can't run a boat on it, though, which is kind of sad. But this will be a pretty fast mode of transportation. We won't really need any other mode of transportation, so just running on it should be absolutely fine. And I went with a little bit of a cool design right here. Purple on the sides, white in the middle. We may not be able to get those in today. I don't think I have all the wool that I'll need for that, but we should get it in pretty darn soon and have a lot of fun with that. So I'm pretty excited, guys. I'm pretty happy with how this tunnel design turned out. Hopefully you all do too. I'm not sure if we're going to complete all of it today, but I at least want to get a few rows of this stuff in and see how it looks in the end and whatnot. So that way we have a better idea of how it actually looks and how you guys will like it as well. So guys, I'm going to go ahead and go back to White's World, get to work on this tunnel, get to work on the Enderman farm as well. I want to bring you guys back. I'll have a lot of progress done, and we may even have a functional Enderman farm. We'll see. I'll see you guys in a sec. About done with this farm. I have the entire thing set up. I have the shoot down set up. I have pretty much everything set up. We just have to do this tunnel, obviously light it up, put some water on it, maybe slab it up or something, so that way we won't have any spawns over it. I don't think they can. Uh-oh, that was a bad idea. I don't know if Enderman can spawn on packed ice, so we'll see if they can. But now I need to get an endermite, because obviously this is an endermite powered farm. So I have my name tag on me, Mighty Mite. Once we get our endermite, I have a minecart, I have our tracks, I have a few ender pearls, but I don't think this is going to be enough ender pearls to spawn an endermite unless we get incredibly lucky, which is possible, but I don't think it's really going to happen. So we'll see. Anyways, let me get started, guys. Let me try to get an endermite, see if I can get it on camera with you guys, and we'll see after that about getting this farm situated. Oh, and one more thing. The tutorial that I used said to put slabs around here, and then they put an annotation saying to put trap doors. Hopefully the trap doors work. We'll see. I don't know. Anyways, let me get started. Well, we got one. We got one. Don't hit me. All right, buddy. So we're going to need to name you. Boom. Muddy Mite. All right. Come on. Get in there. Come on, buddy. Come on. You got this. Follow me. Come on, buddy. Get in there. He's in. Yes, we got him. Ow. Now, how am I going to move this thing? I assume I'm going to have to go. Okay, so let's take these rails out. Grab some rails. Put you there. Put you there. Wrong way, sir. Wrong way. All right, can we put another rail underneath of here? This way. There we go. Take you out. Place a trapdoor there. That should work. He should be stationary in the middle. Hopefully that will work. We've got our endermite. That actually went a lot quicker than I expected, honestly. I expected us to go through an entire stack. We didn't even go through an entire stack of enderpearls. So I'm pretty happy with that. So this should work now. So essentially, if you guys don't know how this sort of enderman farm worked, of course, the tutorial that I'm using, that I'm basing this off of, is down in the description below, as well as in the card up in the top right-hand corner of your screen. But essentially, endermen are attracted and want to kill endermites. So what they're going to do is whenever we get rid of all these torches and put the endermites or the endermen, allow the endermen to spawn, they will track to this guy in the middle, rush towards him. And in doing so and trying to get as close to him as possible to try to kill him, they will find their way into this area, this too wide area where they will drop down in this chute, hit the bottom, and we'll have a good time killing them. So that's essentially how this works. It's not too difficult to understand, I guess, but we still have a lot more work to do. Before we can even try to run this farm, I am going to need to do a lot of work spawn proofing some of the outside areas with slabs and whatnot. That way there is no possible way for them to spawn outside down below while we're killing the Enderman, which we may end up failing at some point. We may end up dying because of this. I may not get everything spawn proofed because, of course, we don't have the tunnel done yet. And I don't necessarily have the supplies yet to get it done, so we'll see if that works out. But guys, I'm gonna go ahead and go off camera and spawn proof everything that I can. Then we'll come back up here, get rid of all the torches, and see how the endermen work. See if we can get a good old enderman farm going today. Hopefully so. All right, I am incredibly nervous right now because I have a bad feeling that something is gonna go wrong. I tried slabbing up the pathway that leads up to here. I know mobs can still spawn on packed ice, so I don't know if that's gonna help at all, but should be torches, so the enderman should stay away, hopefully. Hopefully the light levels are good enough. I'm also really worried that this enderman's either gonna this endermite is gonna despawn, or something really bad's gonna happen to it. So I'm starting from the inside, going out, seeing if we get any endermen to spawn. Oh man, this is nerve-wracking. This is the one thing I hate about ender... Ooh, there we go. Looks like some of them aren't becoming aggravated though. Oh, there we go. All right, so that's working. That's good to hear. I wonder if there are any endermen spawning below though. There shouldn't be any spawning inside of the place, but there could be some spawning outside. Oh, there we go. Yeah, baby, that's working. All right. Well, at least we know it works. And that the endermite's not dying. That's a good thing. Let's get rid of the rest of these torches. All right, even more coming. That's awesome. Once we get down there, though, I'm really hoping that we're not going to find any endermen outside of the little chute. Because if we do, that's not a good thing. That's really not a good thing. And I'll have to do some tweaks to our tunnel or something like that in order to fix that. So why don't we get these torches down? All right, could we get even more spawning? Lots spawning, my gosh. That's a lot of endermen. That thing's gonna be full once we get down to it. All right, get rid of all these torches. So this side should be completely done. I also decided for this upper portion here, by the way, to use full blocks instead of, I could have just used slabs, like stone slabs or stone brick slabs on the top half of the block. At least I think I could have. I decided to go with full blocks though, simply because I was a little worried that the only having a half slab would mess with things. So I decided to go with a full block just to be safe. So I used up a whole bunch of stone, but that's all right. We still have a whole bunch of stone from our mine area, so I'm not too worried about running out of resources or anything like that. Almost done taking down these torches. Enderman is still doing pretty good. That's awesome. And the last of the torches are gone. This place is completely spawnable. That's awesome. Now, hopefully they're not mad at me. The good thing is that they're spawning and they are going exactly where I want them to go. So let's head down. Anybody spawning down here? Oh. Yeah, there are some teleporting on the outside. Interesting. We're gonna have to put some... Yeah, we're gonna need to put some water on top of there. But they're not mad at me, which is good. Yeah, they're teleporting inside and outside of that place. All right. Looks good, but once we start hitting them, we're gonna die. So I'm not gonna hit them. We do know that this works now, though. But I have a lot to do on this place after this episode. I need to get water flowing. I need to finish this tunnel, get water flowing. I gotta make sure that there are no mobs that are gonna spawn in this tunnel. Or are that gonna teleport in this tunnel? One of the things I was thinking about, obviously I need carpet for this place as well. I was thinking about not putting carpet on here. The issue is obviously with the spawns. I wanna make sure that no endermen are gonna teleport here, are gonna spawn here. So I think I am gonna put carpet on here with, you know, the, I think it's gonna be purple on the outside and white in the middle, or white in the middle, or white on the outside and purple in the middle. We'll see. We'll see what I actually go with for this endermen farm. But the good thing is it does work. It does work quite efficiently. And it looks like it's gonna serve us pretty well in the future, as long as we don't die to some Enderman. And as soon as we come here, yeah, it just starts filling up. Let's not look at one either. That'd be a bad thing. But yeah, it's working pretty well. It's looking pretty good. We have a lot to work to do, a lot of work to do. But guys, that is where I'm going to end things for today. If you have any suggestions for me for this Enderman farm, be sure to leave them down in the comment section below. I will always be looking at comments to see they may not be implemented for an episode or two, but they will be implemented at some point. But like I said, guys, that's going to do it for today's episode. Hope y'all enjoyed. If you did enjoy the video, go ahead, smash that like button, leave a comment, and subscribe to the channel if you're new and or not already subscribed. Anyways, guys, take care, and I'll see you later.